Hey guys, it's Jen. Welcome back. So I wanted to put together this makeup tutorial for you. It's such a pretty summer look, and this gorgeous pop of purple in the inner corner I'm so in love with. It's like a beautiful chrome lavender color, like a mermaid type color. And the eye look is actually super simple. Not a lot of detail goes into it at all, even though it looks like you put a ton of effort in. I was inspired to do this look by my latest BoxyCharm subscription box, where I got two Makeup Geek eyeshadows. One was the Duochrome Shadow and Backlit, which is this color, and the other was Cocoa Bear, and you'll see both of those in action in the tutorial. But needless to say, I was super excited to receive two of those eyeshadows in my box because I love her makeup line. So if you're interested in how to achieve this look, definitely keep watching. To prep my face, I'm starting out with the Dr. Jart Ceramiding Cream, and I'm adding in a few drops of the Vita Liberata Self-Tanning Anti-Aging Serum. I've been loving this. It's not only an anti-aging serum, but it's a gradual self-tanner. So you can add it in to your daily moisturizer and it'll build up a gradual self-tan. Or you can use it by itself if you want your tan to build up faster. So it adds brightness and color back into your complexion while anti-aging your skin, so can't beat that. For primer, I'm using the Touch and Soul Feel Like Honeymoon. This is a new product for me. I actually got a sample of this product in a Sephora box and fell in love with it, so I bought the full size. I've been loving this as a skin base. The way it sits on your skin, as you're applying it, it starts to feel a little sticky, but as it sets, the stickiness goes away and it just smooths everything out and your makeup just glides on. So the eyeshadows I'm using outside of the two Makeup Geek colors that are going to be the main focus of the look are going to be out of the Lorac Pro Mega Palette. The first color I'm going to go into is Bisque to highlight the brow bone. You can definitely substitute any of these colors. All the colors I'm using out of the Lorac Mega will be pretty neutral colors. Next, I'm picking up Melon, and I'm just lightly adding this into the crease for a transition color. And I'm using a larger, fluffier blending brush to do this. This is the Sigma E35. Next, I'm taking Cocoa Bear, which is a Makeup Geek shadow. Such a beautiful, warm, matte brown that I've seen used a lot on YouTube, and this actually was another one of the products that came in the BoxyCharm box. To apply the Cocoa Bear, I'm using the Deluxe Crease Brush by Crown Brush. I just got this brush, and I love it so much. It makes my life so much easier. Before moving on to our next pop of color, I'm going to take that same brush that I went into the transition color with, the Melon, and I'm just going to slightly just work in little circular motions to blend out any unblended areas between the two colors. The next eyeshadow color I'm going on with is another Makeup Geek shadow. This is one of her Duochrome eyeshadows. It is beautiful, and I know my camera isn't going to do it justice, but I'm in love with this color. It's called Backlit. So I know it looks kind of crazy right now, but once I finish the look, it's all going to come together, and this color is everything. It's literally like a mermaid color. For my eyeliner, I'm using the Mica Beauty Cosmetics Gel Eyeliner in black and my MAC 210 brush. Of course, to tightline, I'm using my Marc Jacobs Ultra Skinny Gel Eyeliner in black. Before I finish up my eyes, I'm going to go ahead and work on my complexion. First, I'm going to cover up any areas on my face that, like blemishes, broken capillaries, this and that. So I'm using the MAC Select Cover Up, and I'm just going to tap that on, and then of course we're going to cover this up with foundation and concealer and all that. For concealer, I'm first going to go on with the Makeup Forever HD Concealer. This one's a little bit dark because all I have is a sample of it. This is in the color Y33. So I'm going to smooth this on with my finger, and then I'm also going to use the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye in the very corner of my eye, because that's where I need the most color correcting and coverage. First, I'm going to use my Anastasia concealer brush to apply that, and then my damp beauty blender. For foundation, I'm using one of my new favorites. It's the Giorgio Armani Maestro Foundation. It is so beautiful. It gives you such a natural skin-like finish to your skin. It's so light and comfortable, yet it has so much coverage. I don't even understand how they do it. For my highlight, I'm using the Givenchy Mr. Light. This stuff is truly amazing. I'm so in love with it. I actually have a sample of it, and I've been like squeezing every little lash drop out of it. So I'm definitely buying the full-size version because this has been my favorite highlighter lately. So for my contour, I'm doing more of like a bronzer type contour, but this is the Maybelline Dream Bronze, so I'm gonna add that to the hollows of my cheeks and then blend it out, and also to my forehead. But then for my jawline, I don't really want that to have any sort of shimmer. I want that to be more shadowy, so I'm gonna go in with the Benefit Hoola. To set my under eye, I'm using the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening. I'm gonna lightly set my foundation with the Milani Multitasker Face Powder. And then I'm taking the Too Faced Soulmates Blushing Bronzer in Carrie & Big. So this was a gift that was sent to me by one of my really good friends, Susie. And Too Faced does some of my favorite bronzers, and this one is very subtle. So it gives you like this wash of color that just has like an airbrushed finish to it. And I'm also gonna use the peach part of it for the blush. Now to finish up these eyes, I'm gonna go back into backlit since I covered up a lot of the color when I was doing my concealer. I don't want anything too crazy on my lower lash line, just like a little something subtle to bring the look together. So this is Melon, that first transition color I used. I'm just like lightly adding this and take a little tiny bit of Cocoa Bear and add that to the outer corner. And then I'm just gonna blend all this together. This is a MAC 217. Now I'm going to go ahead and add some lashes. I'm using the Kiss 11s. I went ahead and added my bottom mascara. I'm using the Lorac Cobra, which works so good on the lower lashes. I just had this little sample and I've been loving it for my bottom lashes. And I did add a little bit of the Urban Decay Yayo. I don't even know if this is still available. This look would really look good with anything added to the lower lash line, like white, skin color, black, either one of those would look great. And while my eyelash glue is drying, I'm gonna go ahead and apply my eyebrow gel to set my brows. This is the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. And of course, you want to go in and conceal eyelash glue and touch up your eyeliner. For my lips, I'm going to line them with Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Pencil in Illegal. And this is a really pretty, like, mauve-y color. And for my lips, I'm actually using more of a peach, so I'm going to mix the two together at the end. This is the Too Faced Melted and Melted Nude. And this is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and don't forget to thumbs up, share, and subscribe if you're not already. Love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.